Welcome, Chieftains, to another edition of Live from the Tribe, in quarantine style, as we create our shows from home.
He is Noah Haskell, and I am Laura Lackman, and together we bring you the Chieftain Student News.
During this pandemic, Governor Newsom introduced the roadmap to reopen California, which includes four phases, and as of May 8th, California entered phase two, meaning lower-risk businesses can reopen while still maintaining social distancing guidelines. Those businesses include bookstores, music stores, clothing stores, and sporting goods, but only for curbside pickup. Meanwhile, golf courses are open under the rule of singles, no walking. So if you want to start heading over to these places, please continue to practice social distancing.
Going out to shop is a rarity now, as most shopping has to be done online. Small businesses specifically have suffered greatly from the pandemic, and it is important that you find a way to support them.
I'm a small business owner of a chain of mystery rooms, probably going about 25 locations deep, mainly attracting in places of malls and hard to reach places where it's cold and or hot in the summertime. So what we're missing is customer traffic, and by missing the customer traffic, we're still obligated to pay rent. Obligated for the loans that we received or were applied for, we have kept everybody on staff. So you can imagine managers, general managers, and the individual employees to help set up, clean, and let alone dictate and help out with the instructions of the rooms, we still kept on staff. So for small business, this virus, based on the amount of locations that we have, someone small, like, you know, my investment group, we're losing about $150,000 a week. So it's gonna be quite a while for us to build back reserve, let alone going back to the major point of the still of the unknown. Thank you very much. I hope this helps.
No matter if you work or who you work for, it serves all of us best to remember this situation affects everyone. Jack French, CSN.
Due to COVID-19, it seems every store, park, and or public space has been shut down. San Diego residents are lucky, though, for our beaches opened in April. However, there are still some restrictions. If you plan on going to the beach, you must be running, walking, or exercising somehow. You can also be in the water, whether it be swimming, surfing, or anything else. Simply, you are not allowed to be sitting around. Police and lifeguards will be patrolling the beaches to make sure that everyone is participating and following the rules. We don't know how long this will last, but hopefully it'll all be over soon and we'll be back to relaxing on our lovely San Diego beaches.
Quarantine in Los Angeles looks a lot different than what we're dealing with here in San Diego. County Public Health Director Dr. Barbara Ferner stated that the stay-at-home order will be extended all the way to August to reduce the spread of coronavirus. LA needs to take extra precautions because it has the greatest number of cases and deaths in all of California. The city will gradually allow more activities, businesses to reopen, and allow more people back to work when it is safe to do so.
On Tuesday, May 12th, Chancellor Timothy White announced that all CSUs are going to be maintained online throughout the fall semester. That's very sad for us to hear, because many of our seniors were looking forward to starting their own college experience. But with this pandemic, the chance of having an in-person experience is looking slimmer than we all thought. Let's hope this all gets better soon, and we can have hope for a cure later this year.
A gap year is typically a year-long break before or after college, during which students engage in educational or developmental activities, like travel or some type of regular work. Studies have shown that people who take a gap year actually get higher grades in college when compared to students who don't take a gap year. Students, especially those who are at risk of academic burnout, can benefit from taking a year off studying so that they can return with more energy and motivation. It is definitely a good idea to take a gap year so you can return to college with more motivation and graduate with better grades.
This is your last chance to get the yearbook. Go to ball4.com/shop/yearbook. Then you enter our school's name, Clairemont High School. Make sure you have San Diego as the city. Then click on yearbook. From there, you enter your details, like your name and your grade. Then you can go ahead and press purchase for this student and proceed to checkout. It's that simple. You can be amazed at what the senior editors have done for you. Is your photo in the yearbook? There's only one way to find out.
Both prom and grad night are sadly canceled. Seniors were notified via letter on April 10th. Those who have paid for their tickets have already been refunded. If Disneyland does host grad night events in the spring of 2021, the PTSA are definitely considering having CHS seniors attend that event. If you or a senior you know has any questions about grad night, please contact csherden@yahoo.com.
If you have a story to tell us, let us know. You can reach out to csn@dsparks@sandy.net. Tell us your story or what your club is up to, and we'll put it on our show.
And thank you, Chieftains, for watching our show.
Click the like button below.
That's all the time we have for this week. Check us out on June 1st for our next Live from the Tribe.
Keep it in orange and blue, Chieftains.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.